Welcome to the Sentinel High School Football Preview. I'm Perry Mattern alongside Jake Adams of the Sentinel, and we have two Sentinel area teams remaining, the Camp Hill Lions in District 3, Single A, and then the Redland Patriots in District 3, Triple A. Let's talk about the Patriots first. They are in the semifinals of the District 3, 3A bracket, and they get a rematch with the Bishop McDevitt Crusaders, who beat Redland 53-31 first time.
Plenty of yards that game, plenty of points that game. Probably wouldn't be surprised if it was the same way, even if it's going to be about 20 degrees out on Saturday.
Right.
You got, obviously, Andre Robinson. I mean, what else are we going to say? He put up 204 yards on them in his first game back, and he's going to be the focal point again on offense.
597 overall for McDevitt in that game. So now let's break this one down. Let's start with McDevitt. Mm-hmm. McDevitt wins if?
They just got to not turn the ball over. I mean, this offense is just in cruise control every week. Their defense does everything it needs to basically stop anyone. I mean, obviously they're 12-0 now. They've earned this record. As long as they keep clean, Marsilio doesn't, you know, get too crazy with his arm. And that running game doesn't really turn the ball over much either. So if they just keep churning out the yards, it should take care of itself. Really, that's all you got
to
do.
I put in the preview, and I think if they give it to Robinson and Robinson is successful, I wouldn't see any reason to go away from
exactly.
That. Now, on the Redland side of the ball, I'm going to propose Redland wins if to you, but
yeah.
I think really it is. They have to play a perfect game.
Yeah, I mean, honestly, I feel like this is the team that if anyone's going to knock off McDevitt this year, it's this team because of what they did in that first game. They had them, you know, they had them there for a little bit, and it got out of hand late, but they have to play the perfect game, like you said. Jeremy Fisher's out. This defense is going to have to step up and
right.
play the game of their lives to stop Robinson in this running game and the passing game too, which doesn't get enough credit. If they do that, this offense showed that they can put up points and hang with them a little bit. And that offense is just going to have to be better, too. They're going to have to, both sides of the ball have to play the game of their lives.
Patriots last time out, and this is why we said McDevitt, mm-hmm. they can't turn the ball over. Reason Redland was in that game for so long, up until the fourth quarter, a couple Marsilio picks, a Keyshawn
yep.
Jenkins fumble as well. So we'll see what Redland can do. They just seem to find ways.
Yeah.
You know, they don't look great statistically, especially on the defensive side of the ball, but they just seem to find ways to hang around and be a pest. Now,
if they can score first, I think that's key.
Yes.
This is such a slow starting team, too.
Right. Star to watch in this game. Sentinel star to watch, and we're going to go with Garrett Scott.
Yeah, because obviously we know what Phil Overton can do running the ball and on defense, too. He's a pretty solid linebacker. But Scott has got to make the perfect decisions, whether it's, you know, in the option game to hand off or not,
right.
or looking to pass. He has got to be crystal clear on all of his reads, make the right throw. He's got to throw it out of bounds. If there's nothing there, you can't force it against this defense because they are opportunistic, and if you give them any shot, this offense will capitalize.
And I think that's another reason why you don't want to get off to a bad start.
Mm-hmm.
You don't want to have to start throwing the ball, something that Redland is not.
They're good, but
right,
yeah.
not great. All right, let's move on to the District 3 Single A championship game. I'll be at the Redland game. Jake will be at this championship
mm-hmm.
game noon Saturday at Hershey Park Stadium. You know, the Lions have really, I wouldn't say been talking about this, but you could tell that this was
yeah.
a goal from day one. They knew they had the talent to be here,
yeah.
and now they're here. Can they finish it off against York Catholic?
Everyone knew that this offense was going to be, you know, putting up points at this rate, and it was just a matter of if the defense would cooperate with them, which it mostly has, and if they could, you know, get the wins where they needed, and they have. They're 9-2 now. They've obviously, you know, done what they needed to do to get to this point. They've got to keep scoring. And last week, they kind of started to run the ball more. The cold weather is obviously going to play a huge factor in this game. But Bill Williams is more than capable, whether he's out wide, he's in the backfield, he's returning kicks, he's in defensive backfield doing whatever. The guy is going to, you know, he's out there to play, and he's going to be relied upon heavily in this game.
Let's talk a little bit about the York Catholic side.
Mm-hmm.
Hakeem Kennard is
yeah.
quite the player, and he's just about, it seems to be, everything. I mean, he's the leading passer for York Catholic,
yep.
1,600 yards, and then by far the leading rusher, over 1,400 yards.
And on defense, he leads the team with picks,
right.
with three, and he's got 50 tackles, too, which is
yeah.
third on the team. This guy does just about everything. So, if you're Camp Hill, I mean, we don't want to say that we ever want to see anyone injured, but if you're Camp Hill, you would almost want to see it. Like, what are they without him?
Well, and I think that's why the scouting report will undoubtedly
yeah.
be all about Hakeem Kennard. So, let's start with Kennard's team, York Catholic. They win if
they play the same kind of defense they played against Steele High. Granted, this defense has not faced a team like Camp Hill more than likely. Steele High's offense isn't nearly this dynamic. But if they can put down that kind of performance again, shut down this running game and force Schuster to be one-dimensional and have to drop back 40 times, Camp Hill can win those kinds of games, but it's going to be a lot harder when it's 20, 25 degrees outside.
Irish have faced some good teams, lost to Berks Catholic earlier this year, but not a team that throws the ball like Camp Hill. I mean, Camp Hill is a different animal for these kind of teams because they haven't seen a team that can spread it out and mix it all around like Schuster does with Hope, Kuntz, Williams, Valetti, all kinds of receivers that he can use. Yep. Now let's go to the Camp Hill side. They win if...
they stop the run. It's been their bugaboo all year. If they stop the run, they're usually good. Bowling Springs almost got them, putting up 300-something yards on them a couple weeks ago, and we've talked about that game quite a bit. If they can settle things down, keep Kennard in check, I mean, you're not going to stop this guy. That's pretty clear right now. But if you can hold him to, let's say, 200 total yards, that's a win right there.
That's a good number right there. Mm-hmm. And you think about a quarterback that does it all passing and rushing, Keontae Lucas of Milton Hershey comes to mind, and that's a guy that burned Camp Hill earlier this year. Camp Hill also a loss to Steele High as well, but they have won five games in a row.
You think Frank Gay is going to point that out too?
Oh, I would completely agree, but Gay was also very happy with his defense's performance last week. They shut down the run pretty good, and that was a DeLone Catholic team that could put it on the ground, move it on the ground, I should say, pretty well as well. All right, our Sentinels start a watch in this game, and because of the personnel of York Catholic, most notably Kennard. We went with a guy that plays both ways in a very big role for Camp Hill.
And this seems like cheating, but going with Bill Williams, I mean, the guy is probably their MVP. I mean, it's pretty easy to say with what he does for them. But it's as they keep going on this run, he's going to be more and more important because he can go out wide, he can go into the slot, he can come out of the backfield, catch passes, block, run, whatever, and he can return kicks and everything like that. He's going to have that kind of game because a lot of defenses, let's face it, especially in the single-A level, aren't able to match up a guy on him. He's not the traditional running back where you just, you stack your front seven, front eight there and shut him down. You've got to have a man on him at all times and know where he is because if not, and you have a linebacker on him, a younger guy who doesn't have the kind of speed, he's going to burn him because that's the matchups they look for. This is very much a matchup-based offense, and they're excellent at exploiting matchups.
And then on the defensive side, he was a second-team mid-Penn Capital performer as a linebacker. And expect him to use his speed to track down Kennard on Saturday. This should be a really fun game for you to watch, I think, especially because a player like Kennard, he's the kind of guy that can change a game. But Camp Hill, we didn't even really talk about Michael Schuster very much. And then you got Michael Hope as well. Very impactful.
I'll tell you what, I'm just looking forward to the free food.
That's what we tend to think about as media members, but so it goes. So these two games, we'll see what we have coming up next week, but we hope that you pick up our Sentinel football tab this week. It'll be in the Friday edition of the paper. It has our Sentinel All-Stars in there. Jake and I actually ended up working pretty hard. Took a lot of time to figure out
The whiteboard got used for once.
The whiteboard did get used. So we hope that you pick that up and head out to some games. You can interact with us at Sentinel HSFB on Twitter.